Several community organizations are teaming up this week, hoping to spread awareness about mental health in our community. And this is all part of Mental Health Awareness Day, MKE. Organizers Pastor Walter Lanier and Mike Lappin joins us now about the events going on Wednesday. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
So one of the key components that you guys have going on Wednesday is the theatrical performance. Tell me, what is that about?
Well, the theatrical performance was written by Brenda Wesley, who's the outreach director for NAMI of Greater Milwaukee. She's a writer, producer, director, butcher, baker, candlestick maker. She does a lot of work, but it's to raise awareness and decrease stigma around mental illness in our community.
And after the theatrical performance, we were talking about this. You said that people are so moved that there's a question and answer portion that people can get answers right then.
It's very important. As I said to you earlier, it's almost, I call it like a sermon, because it really does evoke and draw people into real life narrative about different challenges, depression, suicidal thoughts, bipolar disorder, PTSD. Those issues are raised in the performance, and then people are drawn to think about it. They may have issues in their own lives or family members' lives, so we open it up, they open it up for questions thereafter.
Mike, 1 in 5 reported cases of people with mental health issues?
Yeah, mental health issues do not discriminate. It doesn't matter your race, your socioeconomic status. It's an equal opportunity disease. Yeah. And so, yeah, most people will be impacted, or a family member will be impacted in their lifetime.
I don't think people realize it's that many people impacted.
It's a very common experience, and unfortunately the stigma that is associated with it keeps people from getting the help they need, because they don't want anyone to find out that they have a mental health challenge. So that's we're really trying to, recovery begins with a connection, so we're trying to make sure folks get connected to services and really get a better understanding of their illness.
Is that exactly what people say when they come for help, is that they didn't want people to know?
Yes.
Yeah, stigma is huge. It is one of the last places where we will not allow people to comfortably say, hey, this is what I have going on in the inside. You can talk about a lot of other diseases, illnesses, or challenges, but, you know, God forbid I have some voices in my mind, or I have major depression or a bipolar disorder or something. We still stigmatize people that talk about that, and so people are traumatized twice. Once because they have the illness, and then again because they cannot share it with those who could help them get some help.
By reducing the stigma, what are you hoping comes of these events that are going on Wednesday and the theatrical performance?
Well, let me start and then I'll go to Mike. So it's at MATC. We've got a rich community there. We've got a broad collaboration of people, two faith-based organizations, two law firms, some sororities. So it's a lot of community stuff that's transpiring there. And once you raise the awareness and decrease the stigma, now we can point people to resources like Behavioral Health Division.
Yeah, you're really getting the word out that people do recover from mental health. It's a health condition, just like cancer or diabetes, that we can help people on the road to recovery, making that connection to that first step or that first thing that is helpful to them. And people, you know, they can live happy, normal lives, and the recovery begins with that connection.
Well, thank you so much for sharing all great information to know. And we have more information on the event at our website. Just head to tmj4.com. And let's